Hi friends, welcome to the third English class based on the lesson Adventures in a Banyan Tree. In our previous class, a task was given to you. Hope all of you have done it, isn't it? Okay. Now before going to the lesson, let us have a glance at our previous class. You know, Adventures in a Banyan Tree is a beautiful story written by Ruskin Bond. Do you know the theme of this story? Yes. In this story, the author tells us to preserve nature in order to make the world a beautiful one. In this story, you can see a beautiful banyan tree, a magnificent banyan tree. And this tree creates a lot of beauty and harmony. How can we say that the tree creates harmony? Yes, during spring season, birds of all kinds would flock into the branches of this tree, and it would become a noisiest place on the road. Then there was another character in this story. Do you remember? Yes. It was a young boy. This boy came to spend his vacation with his grandparents in Dehra. And whenever he got time, he used to spend his leisure time. How did he spend his leisure time? Yes, he used to spend most of his leisure time sitting on this banyan tree. And did he do anything there? Yes. While sitting on the banyan tree, he read different kinds of books. He read not only books. While sitting on the banyan tree, he used to observe the things around him. And every day he used to see the same things happening around him. And one particular afternoon, something special happened. Can you say what it is? Yes. He happened to see a mongoose and cobra fight, a terrible fight between a mongoose and cobra. You know, mongoose and cobra both are very aggressive. They are strong fighters, so we can expect a terrible fight there. Okay. Then our author, Ruskin Bond, he has described this fight as the battle of champions. Yes, you can see the battle of champions. So we can see what happens to this cobra and mongoose. So now I will read the text for you. Meanwhile, you underline the difficult words. Okay? Yes. Hissing defiance, his forked tongue darting in and out, the cobra raised 3 of his 6 feet off the ground and spread his broad, spectacled hood. The mongoose pushed his tail. The long hair on his spine stood up. In the past, the very thickness of his hair had saved him from bites that would have been fatal to others. Though the combatants were unaware of my presence in the banyan tree, they soon became aware of the arrival of 2 other spectators. One was a myna and the other a jungle crow, not the wily urban crow. They had seen these preparations for battle and had settled on the cactus to watch the outcome. Had they been content only to watch, all would have been well with both of them. The cobra stood on the defensive, swaying slowly from side to side, trying to mesmerize the mongoose into making a false move. But the mongoose knew the power of his opponent's glassy, unwinking eyes and refused to meet them. Instead, he fixed his gaze at a point just below the cobra's hood and opened the attack. Moving forward quickly until he was just within the cobra's reach, he made a feint to one side. Immediately, the cobra struck. His great hood came down so swiftly that I thought nothing could save the mongoose. But the little fellow jumped neatly to one side and darted in as swiftly as the cobra, biting the snake on the back and darting away again out of reach. The moment the cobra struck, the crow and the mynah hurled themselves at him, only to collide heavily in midair. Striking at each other, they returned to the cactus plant. A few drops of blood glistened on the cobra's back. The cobra struck again and missed. Again the mongoose sprang aside, jumped in and bit. Again the birds dived at the snake, bumped into each other instead, and returned striking to the safety of the cactus. Dear children, hope all of you have gone through the text. Have you underlined the difficult words? Okay. The first word is defiance. You can see here, defiance means challenge to fight. Challenge to fight. With hissing defiance, the cobra challenged the mongoose. Defiance. Okay, the next word, dart, sudden and rapid motion, means sudden motion of these two animals, cobra and mongoose. They move, their movements are very quick. Next word, bush. Have you heard the word bush? Yes. Bush means bring in the shape of a bush. Bring to the shape of a bush. The mongoose bushed its tail. The mongoose bushed its tail. For what purpose the mongoose is bushing its tail? In order to escape from the enemies, they got a long hair, and this mongoose, in order to protect itself from the enemies, it bushed its tail and the hair on the backbone, spine on the backbone, so that they wouldn't get the snake bite. Okay. The next word, fatal, means deadly attack of these animals, terrible attack. Next word, combatants means fighters, the mongoose and the cobra, fighters. Then spectators. There were two spectators. Did you notice? Two spectators, one is mynah and the other one is a jungle crow. They were watching this battle. Spectators, onlookers. Next one, wily, tricky, clever, the crow, wily crow. Note the word, wily, clever crow. Outcome means the result. Next word, content. Content means satisfied. If these birds, mynah and the jungle crow, they were satisfied, if they were contented with that battle, satisfied, nothing would have happened to them. Next one, forked tongue. Tongue, it's a familiar word to you, but forked tongue, what is meant by forked tongue? See, with one end divided into two parts. The forked tongue of the cobra divided into one end divided into two parts. Next one, defensive, self-protective, defensive, self-protect. Opponent, who was the opponent of the mongoose? Cobra, opponent, cobra, enemy. Next one, unwinking. Unwinking means steady, unwinking eyes, without winging. Unwinking, winging, opposite. Winging means winging the eyes. Unwinging, steady eyes, without winging the eyes. Next one, gaze. Gaze means look. Faint, pretentious move. See, the cobra was trying to attract the mongoose by making a pretentious move, swaying slowly from one side to other. Pretentious move, feigned move. Next word, hurl, to throw heavily, to throw violently. Hurled themselves when the terrible fight was going on, both these birds, they hurled each other. Throw violently. They were overwhelmed with joy and they threw violently, both of them. Collided. Collide means hit. Striking cry of these birds. Strike means sharp cry. Okay. Next one, glisten. The blood glistened on cobra's back. Means to shine brightly. To shine brightly. Sprang. Sprang means jump. Bump. Bump means smashed. They bombed each other. These two birds, they bombed each other. Hit each other. Did you get the meaning of the new words? Okay. Now, you watch this video and also listen to this commentary. I will be back with some questions. Okay. Dear friends, now we are going to watch a terrible fight between two opponents. One is a cobra and the other one is a mongoose. See, both of them has come face to face in a clearing beneath the tree. The gray mongoose is only 3 feet long, but no doubt he is a superb fighter, clever and aggressive. The opponent cobra is also not bad. He is a skillful and experienced fighter. He could move swiftly and strike with the speed of light. Look, the fight is started. The cobra, with a hissing defiance, it is darting his forked tongue in and out. Oh, what a splendid sight! The cobra has raised 3 of his 6 feet off the ground and has spread his broad, spectacled hood. See the mongoose. It has pushed its tail. I think it is getting ready for the fight. The long hair on his spine has stood up. I think he's trying to save himself from snake bite. Yes, terrible fight is going on. See, the cobra is trying to mesmerize the mongoose, swaying slowly from side to side. Sure, it is going to mark a false move, but I think the mongoose is well aware of the glossy, unwinking eyes of his opponent. He has fixed his gaze at a point just below the cobra's hood. Oh, what a darting movement! The mongoose has wonderfully escaped from the cobra's track. The little fellow is very, very clever. Yes, his movements are very swift. Wow, it has bitten the snake on its back. Now let me turn towards the two spectators, the mynah and the jungle crow. They are overwhelmed with joy. They had settled on the cactus to watch the outcome. Alas, they collided heavily in midair
striking each other. Look, a few drops of blood has glistened on the cobra's back. His rage has increased. Both are strong opponents. The winner is beyond our prediction. Terrible fight is going on between mongoose and cobra. We can wait and see what will happen to the mongoose and the cobra, who will win the game in the third round.
Have you enjoyed the commentary? Okay. Now, listen to the first question. How did the cobra get ready for the fight? How did the cobra get ready for the fight? Do you know? Yes, with a hissing defiance, it darted its forked tongue in and out. Then, what did it do? It raised 3 feet off the ground and spread its broad spectacled hood. Spectacle means resembling the spectacles. Okay. Then, how did the mongoose also, both are equally opponents, both are strong and clever, and the mongoose also made some preparations. Can you say what it is? Yes. The mongoose, what did it do? The mongoose pushed his tail. Then what happened? The long hair on his spine stood up. For what purpose they are doing like that? In order to protect themselves from the enemies. Okay. Then, we also saw 2 spectators there. Can you identify the spectators? Who are the spectators? Yes, a crow and a myna. They were watching the terrible fight. Okay. Then, what technique did the cobra implement during the fight? The cobra tried to implement certain techniques. What was that? The cobra stood on the defensive, then it swayed slowly from one side to other. For what purpose? To mesmerize the mongoose into making a false move. The cobra swayed slowly from one side to other in order to mesmerize the mongoose, making a false move. And see the next one. How did the mongoose prove that he was clever? How did the mongoose prove that he was clever? The mongoose was well aware of the opponent's glassy, unwinking eyes. Glassy, unwinking eyes, and refused to meet them. And instead, he fixed his gaze at a point just below the cobra's hood. It fixed a point just below the cobra's hood. Then, the last one. Can you find out the reactions of the spectators when the cobra struck? Both the spectators, the crow and the myna, they were watching the terrible fight. And how did they react? They were overwhelmed with joy, isn't it? And the moment the cobra struck the mongoose, the crow and the myna, they hurled themselves at him. They hurled themselves at him. And what happened? As a result, they collided heavily in mid-air, striking at each other. Now, you have seen a terrible fight between The first two rounds of the terrible fight between mongoose and cobra. And it is beyond our prediction who will win the fight, because both are equally strong, both are clever and aggressive, so we can't predict who will win. Okay. So I know that you are eagerly waiting for the third round. So before that, I will give you some tasks. You do activity 3 on page number 16. Activity 3 given in page number 16. And also try to write a commentary of the first two rounds of the fight between cobra and mongoose. Okay, now it is time to wind up. Thank you.